Hello, it is me, Leo, again, and in today's video we're going to be showcasing my level 10 grassland village. Like I told you in the previous episode, I can use my launch pad to make it all the way to my grassland village, and that is what we're going to do today. Get a nice view of the ocean. And in the back, you can see the dry valley. And as of right now, you should be able to see my grassland village as it is getting nighttime. Alright, well, we're just going to wait until it turns to daytime. So I will see you guys in a bit. And we are back. As you can see, during the nighttime, we had a lot of visitors coming around trying to break stuff. So, again, welcome. This is my level 10 grassland village. One thing that this village has that my snow villages have to worry about, neither does my dry valley village have to worry about, is the skeletons, the dudes that like come up late at night. Since I have a little border around my snow village, they don't have to worry about that too much. Although at times they do wind up spawning inside the village, but it's not as badly as it used to be as before I had put the border around it. All right, as you can see in the distance, we have some corn. When I first found this area, it was a big old corn field. I knocked some corn down and made this little area a nice village. These are all of my villagers. Now, Sky, you guys let me know down in the comments below. I was thinking about getting rid of Sky one time before because she has a little attitude. I don't know if it's just in my world, but she has an attitude at times when you talk to her. So let's go see what Mayasos has for me today. Wheat, fine, and fertilizer, I pick that up some other time. Now let's just emote to get everybody here. Alright, and look who it is, Sky. Alright, what do you have for me? Cut amber. And we're missing, okay, he's in here, Mr. Peely. And I have enough stuff, I think, to make some grapples. Alright, so if you guys was wondering why do I have this opening right here, it is because back when I first made this building, there was a pine tree like this one right over here. It was like growing inside of it, and I thought by me like destroying it, it destroyed it. But I come back the next day and it didn't get destroyed. It grew right back. So I was like, it grew like right here in the middle. And so I was like, I can't really use this door to get over here. So I'm just gonna put an opening over here to be able to get inside. And then a little bit later, I found out the way to get rid of it. I did not know you had to dig it out. But I never did like fill it back in and put the wall up. I just left it like this. So yeah, this is the reason why this opening is right here. But as you can see, we have our spinning wheel right here. Have a chest right here, some stuff that you can use for the spinning wheel, and a little chest right here. This is where I keep all of my rods at. And this right here is where I kept all of my marble and granite at. Then over here, like I had wanted to use this as my house. And as you can see with the roofs I was telling you about, it's the only time where you'll see like a normal roof on top of a house is when it's a prefab. Like those two over there, you will see like foundations or wooden foundations or concrete foundations or flooring that I will use for a rooftop. But as we go inside, just one bed and just a couple of chests. Yeah, I'm not really a decorator. I just like build this stuff and I just let it be. Kind of sucks that the grass is like coming up in the buildings. And then after I noticed that, I will show you what I started doing in my other two buildings right over there once we reach it. And over here, this was used to be the kitchen area, but I like moved everything. As you can see, got some food right here. I could never figure out how to get the refrigerator. So if you guys know how I would get the fridge, just let me know down in the comments below. And over here, this was my bed. Like I had their beds, all the villagers' beds outside in these little shacks. But the thing was, it's out here in the opening, and as you saw earlier, late at night we have visitors coming around here, and there was a couple of times that they got my villagers and the visitors got into a brawl and it destroyed their bed. So I was like, I didn't want to lose them, so that's why I decided to build this right here behind me, and I put their beds in there. As you can see, we got our crafting bench right here, a bed, lumber mill, a bed, and a couple of chests. And then here is the villagers' bedroom. And I got them a little campfire. And I got in here more of my tools and stuff, and another, some more chests. You might be wondering why I have, like, I guess you can say, like, these low-grade chests. It's because I didn't have much stuff at the start and I had a lot of planks, and I thought during then it was better to have those types of chests. So I just pretty much just put a bunch of those chests around this whole village. And here is a couple more chests. This is one I got when I went like to the Dry Valley. I started getting like more materials and I just started like dumping stuff in here. Some more storage. Now, I don't really stay in this village that much no more, so that's why at times you see like some of my chests are kind of empty. It's because I mostly stay in my snow village now. And here's my bed right here. I'm gonna have a little balcony, and the reason why I built a balcony is because before the update, all the villagers would just pile up to this door right here, and I couldn't get inside. I had to like figure out a way to like open up the door. They like pile in front of the door, and then sometimes they like pile in behind the door, and all you could see was like talk to the visitors. I could never like get the prompt to open up the door, so that's why I built this little stairway to get upside inside of here. Now on to what I was thinking about earlier with the grass. I figured out that I could just like build the buildings on top of like the smaller walls. So that's what I did right here. I kind of messed it up because I didn't get this back filled in, or this side over here filled in with the these walls right here, but it looks all right. And over here is my little greenhouse. You might be wondering why I call it a greenhouse, and I will show you in a little bit. And as you can see, more wood plank chests. Got a good amount of like stuff in here that I can still use from time to time. Here's my smelter, my oven, my stone breaker, and my loom. And this is why I call it a greenhouse. I have my little garden right here. I got this part right here opened up for the rains, like if it like rains or whatever, it can water the garden for me. And then this part over here is covered up, because I want this part right here to get wet. So yeah. And then you can see more of the corn in the background. Now this right here, I wish I could figure out how to do, like replicate this right here, because I kind of like how this like acts like a little stair, but I wouldn't know how to do it. So yeah, that is my level 10 grassland village. So again, if you would like to see my level 10 drive a valley village, please let me know down in the comments below. I thank you guys for stopping by and watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. As I said in the previous video, I am trying to push to become a epic part and get me a code in the item shop and stuff like that. So yeah. So I will see you guys next time. Thanks again for stopping by and watching, and you guys take care.